Hey guys, I'm back with a Transformers review, and today I'm doing the Transformers Revenge of the Fallen Voyager Class Stratosphere, who is exactly as good as I expected. I was not overly impressed. I was not really overly let down. That's a rarity for me with these figures. He is, of course, a cargo plane, a massive one. You could say this is the one that was used in the beginning sequence, which dropped off Optimus in Shanghai. You could. His bio states that he is used to transport the Autobots around the world, so okie dokie. He is rather small. To show you how big he is, here's a figure everybody should have by now. Here he is next to Voyager Class Starscream. He is very, very, very out of scale. And I've said this before many, many times. I would love to see a bigger version of him. It just, he has a lot of potential. I really do like his robot mode. It's just, it's so small, it's not really that super. He does roll fairly well. He has one wheel here. The rest of these, I don't know why they couldn't really do wheels all through here. It wouldn't have been that much more expensive, I would imagine. He has a flip-down wheel in the front here, and it folds right up. And also, these little panels do fold in and out. So, he has one more major gimmick in this mode. When you have him sitting flat, when you rotate his little tail section, we should get, and rotate, come on, oh, ready, here we go, bonk, a little ramp comes down with a little teeny tiny Optimus Prime. This is teeny, eeny, beeny, weeny, geeny Prime, and it's honestly not that great, something special. If you do want to transform it for whatever reason, the legs fold down. This little back panel here will fold out to give him heels, although it is a bit of a challenge to flip it out because it's so freaking little. It's not even really worth it. It's just... Eh. Yay. That's Prime. And it just pretty much goes to help show you how much larger this thing would have to be to actually be remotely scale. So pretend that this Prime is leader class, and you know, this is let's say Prime's a foot tall. Oh, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It'd have to be about 6, 7 feet tall or long to be scale accurate. And of course, that's ridiculous. We were not going to have that. Okay, little bonus thing, not really worth it. Now we saw a long time ago, in test shot photos, maybe even prototype, that Stratosphere was meant to come with a little shuttle accessory that would kind of mount on here. Sadly, that was cut, and I still don't know why. I think that would have been a fantastic accessory to include. It also became a gun for him in his robot mode. I don't know why it was cut. But there's Stratosphere in his plane mode. Fancy dancy. One side of these is really tight. One side of these is really loose. And that's really about it. Now to transform him, you're going to squeeze these two little panels here in to kind of detach them from this lower section. You can see how it pops off there. And you're going to fold that up with the wings. And they fit in there really, really snug. So there's this. And I'm going to zoom out a teeny tad. What's that is done, you got the legs here. Fold this section down. And you're going to rotate the legs. It does help to separate them. You're going to rotate them so this stuff folds back this way. Kind of work it around. A little bit of force is necessary. And then you got this whole array kind of stretched out here. Fold this. This will be his feet. And you can leave his legs straight if you want. You can fold them to their wackiness now or later. It doesn't really matter to me. I don't know. Now this is where his MechaLife gimmick comes in. When you spin his arms out, you may notice this section here moves out on its own. Nook. Dunk. Cool little gimmick. It's definitely not the worst I've seen from MechaLive. You have to leave Prime out when you're transferring him because this whole panel will not click in place with him inside of there. You can see that's where Prime would be stored. So you're going to fold all this stuff down and then a little hole, a little peg. Before you do that, make sure you push up his head. And then put those together. And fold, you can fold these back. I leave them down like this. The instructions have them to kind of be in this position. That sounds to be in this position. That's really bad grammar. I don't know. You can have his wings kind of down at this angle. You can have them straight up if you want. It's really up to you at this point. But again, I leave those down flat just to get him out of the way. Get his arms turned in the right position. Elbows facing forward. And now this is where you can either have him standing completely straight up. You have to get these little parts of his legs straight. And he does look a bit goofy this way. I'm going to tilt this up some. Zoom in some. I probably tilted a little too high. But you can have him like this where he stands up really, really, really weird. The instructions say to have him with the kind of Starscream type legs where they're all bent weird. And he actually looks better this way. It makes him look a lot meatier, I guess, in a way. It's kind of weird, the perspective of my camera right now. It looks like he's right against the wall, and I know this is just amusing me at this moment. But really, it's like, I mean, I find that funny. I'm easily amused. I know. But that is Stratosphere. And I like the guy. I really do. I don't think he's worth $20, though. I know. Once again, he's one of those figures I got on sale for $10 through Amazon. $10, fantastic deal. $20, it's not bad. You may notice that he does have this kind of bright orange on his arms. If these haven't painted more of a flat black, they would look a whole lot better. I don't know why they are orange. His head sculpt is not that bad at all. In there. And I really do like this guy. I like, you know, all the detail sculpted in his chest right through here. I just like the way he looks. Even his big, goofy feet. I just like him. And I think he has light piping, which he does. So, get him here. And you can see, he does have light piping. It's kind of hard to get it. There you go. I like this guy. I really, really do. It's just, I know he would never get a leader class figure, a Supreme figure like that, because he didn't appear in the movie. So, that's not going to happen. It's just, I really do like the way he looks overall. Articulation-wise, arms can swing all the way around. However, they will hit his wings occasionally. So, you know, eh. They do rotate. They rotate above the elbow. He has a double elbow joint and a little MechaLive type thing. If you look, the little gears in his arms actually move when you bend his elbow. And it's really, really hard to show that. Because they are really, really teeny tiny. But you can see that there. The same with these here. But bend his elbow, they will spin. His fingers can open. His thumb can open and close. I like this guy. No waist movement. His legs can go pretty high up. They can go pretty high back. A full-on dash. And you can have him swinging outwards. He has this. He has a joint here, so you can bend his knee here. You can bend it here. And you can bend it at his ankle somewhat. I like this guy. I really, really do. I know a lot of people don't, and I can understand why. He does look a tad off, but for some reason that I have no idea why, I just think he looks like a really cool robot. He does look kind of more like a robot type thing than an actual Transformer. So that's it, guys. I would recommend picking him up. If you don't want for $20, wait a little bit. You should be able to find him on clearance at some point. I think he is a nice figure for your collection. He just looks, he's just a fun toy. Oh, also, I forgot to mention, his head can rotate. worth noting, I guess. But that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.